Hello everyone, this is the Appery team, and in this video, we want to show you how to configure push notifications for iOS devices. In the previous video, we showed you how to do the same for Android. If you haven't seen that video, we recommend watching it. In real life, you would configure push notifications in one application for both Android and iOS, but in our video, we will do this in a new application. So, let's create our new application. If you remember, we need to enable the push Cordova plugin. Then, we need to go to the iOS binary section. Unlike Android, we cannot install any applications on iOS devices, and our applications must be signed in a specific way. We need to specify the certificate and provision profile. In one of our previous videos, we already showed how to configure them, but in this video, we decided to show it again. So, let's start from the very beginning. We scroll up and need to copy our bundle ID. Then, we go to the Apple Developer Console. If you don't have an account, you need to create one. Here, we need to create an identifier for our application. Click the plus button and specify that it will be an app ID. Here, we specify our bundle ID. Let's add a description. A very important point. We need to specify that our application will use push notifications capability. Find it in the list and enable. Then click Continue and Register. We just created our new application, and here it is in the list. In the next step, we need to create a certificate. Go to the Certificates section. Click the plus button and specify that we need an Apple Developer Certificate. Here, we need to specify a certificate request. To get it, go back to Appery. Go to the Resources section and click the Generate Certificate button. Select the iOS platform. Click Continue and then download the certificate request. Return to the Apple Developer Console. Click the Choose File button and select the certificate request you just downloaded. Click Continue and download. Then we return to Appery again. Select the certificate you just downloaded. Specify the name and also the password, and click the Generate button. We just created our certificate, which can be used to sign developer build of our application. You can see until what date our certificate will be valid. And also, we need to specify this certificate in the certificate section of our application. If it's not here, click the refresh button and specify it. We also need a provision profile. To do this, go back to the Apple Developer Console. But before creating it, we need to register our device. Go to the Devices section. Here, we need to click the plus button. Specify the device name and the device UDID. The hardest part here is finding the UDID of your device. To do this, open iTunes and in the summary section of your iOS device, you need to click here several times. We got UDID of our device. You can right-click and copy it. Then you can paste it here. Specify its name and click continue. Here I see the warning that my device was added early, so I will click the back button. Now we can create our profile. Go to the Profiles section, click the plus button, select iOS App Development. Select our application from the list. Here we need to choose our certificate. I select all certificates. Here we specify which devices our application might be installed on. Again, select all devices and continue. Specify the name of our profile and generate it. Now we can download it. After that, go back to Appery and click the Change button for the provision profile. Then click Upload, select the file, and choose the provision profile you just downloaded. We have one more small step left. To do this, return to the main page in Appery. Select the Push Notifications section for the application. Enable the Push Notifications checkbox. Then we need to specify the database where the tokens of our devices will be stored. And again in a real application, both Android and iOS devices will be stored in one database. Since we are conducting a completely clean experiment, let's go to the Databases section and create a new database. Specify the database name and create it. Now go back. Click Select Database and choose the newly created database. Now we can return to our application and build our binary IPA file. Our application is ready. Let's install it. Scan the QR code and select Install. Our application is installed. we can open it. Here we need to grant permission to receive push notifications. Let's minimize the application. Our application is ready to receive push notifications. Now go back to Appery, and if we scroll down, we will see that to send push notifications we need to upload a push notification certificate. To create it, we need to go back to the Apple Developer Console. Go to the Identifiers section. Select our application. Find the Push Notification section and see that there is a Configure button here. Click it. Here we can create a certificate for sending push notifications. This can be a development or production certificate. But since we have a debug build, we need a development certificate. Here we need to upload a certificate request again. Returning to Appery, click the button to create a certificate. Select iOS and download the certificate request for sending push notifications. Go to the Apple Developer Console and upload the certificate request you just downloaded. Click Continue, and then download the Apple Push Notification Certificate. We need to upload this certificate to Appery. Select it, specify the name, password, and click the Create button. We need to specify this certificate on the main page. To do this, export it in P12 format. Return to the main page and upload it. Also remember to specify the password. If you recall, we already launched our application, and if we go to the database, we can see that a new device has appeared in the devices collection. Its type is I, indicating it is an iOS device. Also here there is a device ID and a token. Return to the main page. Go to the Send Push Notification section. Select the type of our device, which is iOS. You can also specify criteria for sending push notifications. In this case, we don't need to. Specify the title and message for the push notification. You can also specify a value for the badge. At the bottom, we can see how many devices were found. Click Send. We see that the push notification was successfully delivered. A badge appeared on the app icon. Swipe down from the top. Click on the notification and go to the app. You can also find a section for additional settings, where you can customize push notifications. We would like to recommend that for testing purposes, you collect not the usual debug build, but a live debug build. This will allow you to immediately see all the changes you make to your app on your phone. It is also necessary to mention that when you publish your app in the Apple Store, the type of your build will be release, and you will need to create a corresponding push notification certificate. To do this, you will need to go to the Identifiers section again, select your app, and create an Apple Push Notification Certificate for the production environment. In the Push Notifications section of Appery, you will need to specify that this is a production certificate. That's all we wanted to show in this video. Be sure to watch our next video, where we will show you how to send push notifications from server code. If you found the video interesting, please like and subscribe. It is very important for us and for YouTube algorithms.